Hey guys, welcome back to the Conservative Patriot. My name is Keith. Hey, so today I'm in my shed just kind of organizing for winter, getting things ready. Kind of trying to put some insulation on the walls. And I'm trying to make this like a winter kind of workshop. When it's colder outside, I can kind of come in here and work, because my garage is not heated. And I have two garages. Nothing is heated. This shed's not heated. So I'm looking to put like one of those, like, I think they're called like Big Buddy heater, propane heaters in here that I can vent outside. So that's my plan. But I want to talk about gun control today. And in my state of Connecticut, I can either open carry or conceal carry, but you need to have one of these bad boys, state permit, to carry pistols or revolvers. And if I wanted to carry a rifle, I need to have my hunting license. So it's on me right now. You can't see it. It's right here. So there it is. So if I want to walk around my property and be more comfortable, I can keep my sweatshirt open like this and just walk around. Going to stores is a little harder, because people kind of freak out a little bit if they see you walking around with a gun. So you just throw it under your sweatshirt. And I have the right to do open carry or concealed carry because of my permit. So just wanted to talk about where the 2020 Democrat candidates stand on gun control, what their differences are, and see how jacked up they are. But go ahead and come try to take this, Bernie Sanders, Joe Biden, Elizabeth Warren, Kamala Harris, Pete Buttigieg, whoever you say your name. Go ahead. Those are the top five candidates, and those are the top five that we're going to kind of go over today. Be right back. Hey guys, welcome back. So you saw my pistol before, and it is the Glock 26 Gen 4. It's a 9mm, and in the state of Connecticut, you can only have 10 rounds. So 10 round magazine, my hollow points, because I'm not taking any chances. So that is what I carry for personal protection. And you know, it's small enough to conceal under my sweatshirt, like you saw before, but it's a good feel in my hand. So that's what I carry. I don't know if you guys have any weapons on your house or for personal protection, but that's what I carry. And I call it a weapon because, again, I was in the Army for a number of years, and it's what it is, man. It's a weapon. It's not a gun. It's for protection. So I took some notes, and let me grab those, but I wanted to go over what these candidates stand for, and as far as what their positions are in gun control, and if these guys get elected, what it would mean for us as Second Amendment followers, gun right advocates, etc., because we believe in our Constitution. So Joe Biden's policies, there's a couple of, and I went on their websites and I found as much information as I could, and I think that a lot of times people who are running for office are kind of, you know, they're being dishonest, but they're not presenting the whole picture. So I got as much information as I could from the top five candidates, which I have, you know, Joe Biden, Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, Kamala Harris, and Pete Buttigieg. That guy's name's crazy. Anyways. So, Joe Biden, and I just highlighted a couple things that were, that really stood out, because a lot of the stuff is standard, we're going to take your guns and you know, we're going to legislate you to death, and criminals are going to just have more power than you do. So Joe Biden, he wants to hold the gun manufacturers accountable for gun crime. So if the owners of Glock... If my Glock or a Glock was in a shooting, they want to hold Glock accountable for that shooting. That's kind of like saying, hey, I'm driving my Saab down the road and I crack into another car. They're going to hold Saab accountable for my accident. Even though Saab's not around anymore, but just saying, you know, or a Ford, whatever. If you're driving your Ford truck down the road, crack into somebody, they're going to hold Ford accountable for the injuries that may occur to the other person that you hit, because it was a Ford truck that caused the accident. Not the person driving it, or the conditions outside, it was the truck that did it. Just like they're saying, the manufacturer did it, not the person who pulled the trigger. Doesn't matter what gun manufacturer it was. He also, this always gets me, they all have this very similar thing. They want to buy back assault weapons. I don't think they really understand what an assault weapon is. An AR-15 is not an assault weapon. Sorry. It's a .223 round or a 5.56 NATO round. It's not an assault weapon. It is the same gun as a Ruger or any other rifle that takes a .223 round. It just has really, you know, military-looking hand grips on it. It's got a handle on top, a carry handle on top that you can hold it. It has a sight bars on there. It's got a charging handle that you pull back and snap the bolt forward. It is not any more or more powerful than a regular .223 hunting rifle. So it just looks scary. It's black and it has all these things hanging off of it. Oh my God, it's got to be more powerful. It does more damage because of the accessories all over it. Nah, same gun. So those are the two things that stood out for Biden. Next is Elizabeth Warren. I think she's the worst on the list. She's an absolute crazy person. She right now, I think that guns are taxed at like 10%, and I think ammo is taxed at maybe like 12 or 15%, something like that. She wants to tax guns at 30% and ammo at 50%. Are you serious? That is ridiculous. Oh, and then she wants to put a gun cap on. So that means, that's saying that I only have one handgun, but if I wanted to buy another one or another, say I wanted to buy like five in a month, just because I'm like, this is great. I want to have all these cool looking guns or weapons around, and some of them are antiques and some, you know, they don't fire, but she's going to put a cap on it saying I can only have four or five or whatever the number that they choose is going to be. Bullshit, man. I can have as many as I can pay for, in my opinion. And then this is very similar to Biden. He also said that he wants to make even minor, like, hate crimes an offense where you're no longer allowed to own a weapon. Such as if I'm in New York City and I go, man, I think that person's an illegal alien, I can now get fined $250,000, or anybody can get fined $250,000 for saying that in New York City. It might even be all of New York State. And that is now considered a hate crime if I say that guy's an illegal alien. Just by me saying illegal alien in New York State, that is now considered a hate crime. And if these guys get in office, they can take my rights away and say you can no longer buy firearms. Kidding me. She wants to expand gun-free zones because those work really well in all the school shootings, because those are all gun-free zones. They work really well, right? Don't they? Yeah, not for the people in the building, but for the shooters that are coming in. They work wonders for, because they know there's nobody in there to take them out. It's a gun-free zone. If I had a gun in there, I would be arrested. I don't understand this. So I was always wondering about this. And for some reason, I forget that I had my my pistol on me, which sometimes I do because it's just kind of like part of my body, carrying it around. So I get out, get my kids off the bus at school, have my gun on me, and a shooter comes in, and I have my gun. I'm the good guy with the gun. I take out the shooter. Am I going to get in trouble? My guess is probably yes, because I illegally brought my gun to a gun-free zone. So she wants to expand the gun-free zones to include colleges and universities, and pretty much at colleges and universities, they're all adults. And if you're an adult and you have your permit, She wants it to apply to everybody who has their legally obtained pistol permit. Ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. She also takes the holding accountability gun manufacturers a step further, and she wants to imprison the executives of that company or those companies if something were to happen. So if a Glock gets in is used in a mass shooting, then she wants to basically hold accountable those executives and put them in jail. Because that makes sense. Let's put the gun manufacturer executives in jail for something that they had nothing to do with. The crazy person with the gun goes to jail, but so does the guy who made it. What kind of bullshit is that? God damn. Moving on to Kamala Harris, who considers herself an African American. That still blows my that blows me away. She is a darker-skinned woman. Just like President Obama was a darker-skinned guy. Was he an African-American because his father was from Kenya? His mother was a white woman from America? Does that make him an African-American? I don't think so. I think it just makes him an American. Just kind of like, you're born here, you're an American. I don't know why I gotta add, like, African or Mexican or whatever American to your name. You're an American if you're born here. So anyways, she's not even... Her history, her father's from Jamaica, and her mother is from India. So there's no African connection in there at all, yet she considers herself an African-American. Anyways, I digress. So one of her big things that stood out was that she wants to ban the AR-15. Again, because it looks scary. So all of her, I mean, she follows along the other paths of Biden and Warren. She kind of... But then she adds in here banning the AR-15. Pete Buttigieg. He had a couple things on his site that actually made sense, which took me by surprise. So he said that, you know, he wants to expand law enforcement's rights and allow them to go back out and enforce the law. Which shocked me because none of the other Democrats are actually saying we need to help law enforcement, provide them with more equipment, more funding to get better gear to combat this, any kind of violence. But he is, which is great. He also said that he wanted to invest more in the Department of Homeland Security to help fight domestic terrorism. That also came as a shocker. But he does have a background in the military. He is a military veteran. So maybe that has a little bit to do with his stance on gun control. But then he said something stupid. It was bound to happen. He said that he wants to ban assault weapons. Now, I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, this guy should know that we don't have assault weapons. The civilian public cannot purchase assault weapons. And he said that, no weapon of war should be able to be purchased by a civilian. No shit, dumbass. There are no weapons of war being purchased by civilians. An AR-15 is not a weapon of war. It's a semi-automatic rifle. A weapon of war would be the military version, which would be an M16, which has increased magazine capacity. It has an automatic weapons selector on it, so you can shoot automatically, not in... And it has 3-round bursts on it, so you can shoot 3-round bursts. It's not just flip it to semi-automatic and go bang, bang, bang. It's or fully automatic. Let it go. That is a military weapon. We can't buy those. They've been banned since the mid '80s. And then I read Bernie Sanders. He's got no real plan on there. It's just a lot of blah, Bernie yelling and making noise and. He's got no plan for gun control. I don't think he's got a plan for anything. He just talks loud. But I thought that was interesting. You know, Biden, Warren, and Harris pretty much all had the same policies. Warren took it so much further than anybody else. At least on her website she did. And maybe she's being honest. She's she's not holding back that she's gonna take our guns away. Biden and Harris and Buttigieg or whatever. I'm sure they all want to do that, but they didn't promote it on their website. I'm sure it's because they don't want to scare anybody. Anyways, that's all I had. I just wanted to spit out some, you know, gun control issues that the top five 2020 Democrat candidates have, and, you know, kind of get your thoughts. They're probably very similar and in line with mine, which, you know, don't take my guns. I'm not a bad guy. Go after the bad guys. They're going to get a gun or a knife or whatever. I mean, look what just happened in France. Four police officers in the police station were killed by a nutjob with a knife. A knife! Four police officers were killed with a knife. So, bad guy's going to do bad stuff regardless of the weapon. Knife, hammer, drill bit, I don't know, gun. There are more deaths, or there is more assaults with knives than there are with guns. So, anyways, I appreciate you guys watching the channel. Do me a favor, hit that subscribe button, hit the bell icon. Something funky is going on with my channel. Subscriber count keeps going up and down. I can't get past 538 subscribers. Not sure what the deal is. It goes to 539. Comes back down to 538. Goes to 539, comes to 538. I don't know if YouTube's messing with me or what, but I was on this trajectory to just keep on going, which is great, and then it just stopped. So do me a favor. Help me out. Hit that subscribe button. Hit the bell icon. Give me a big thumbs up. Tell your friends about it, and always remember to stay on the right side. Have a great day.